Good morning everyone. Today we will discuss about pollination, the types of pollination and contrivances of the pollination, that is self and cross pollination. First of all, let me to define what is pollination. Pollination is the process of the transfer of pollen grains from anther of the stamen to the stigma of the carpel. So this transferring of the pollen grains from anther to the stigma of the carpel, this is called pollination. The process of pollination is of two types. I have written here self-pollination and cross-pollination. Before I start these two types of the pollination, I request you all to take the notebook and pen and write down all the topics, the keywords, so it will be easy for you during the revision time. Self-pollination. What is self-pollination? Self-pollination is the transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma of the same plant. Overall, if the process of pollination takes place within the same plant, this process is called, this type of pollination is called self-pollination. The self-pollination is further divided into two types, autogamy and geitonogamy. What is autogamy? Autogamy is the pollination within the same flower. If the flower is bisexual, means the male and female, both of the sex organs are present within the same flower, these flowers generally, they prefer autogamy, means the pollination, or you can say the transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma of the same flower, and this is called autogamy. It takes place in some of the plants like wheat, rice, pea, mustard, etc. All these flowers of these plants, they are bisexual, they have bisexual flowers, and the bisexual flowers generally they prefer autogamy. Some conditions are there, we will discuss later on. Now the geitonogamy is the transfer of the pollen grains from one flower to the another flower, but on the same plant. Like in the case of cucurbita, this plant has the unisexual flower. Either the flower is male or the flower is female, but both the male and female flowers, both they are present on the same plant. The plant is monoecious. In both of the cases, the plants are monoecious, but the condition, the process of geitonogamy occurs from one flower to the another flower, but the plant is same. Why autogamy and geitonogamy both are considered, both are included in this heading in self-pollination? As I told you, self-pollination, in the self-pollination, pollination occurs in the same plant. And that's why the autogamy and jitnogamy both are the types of self-pollination. Once again, let me to define. So in autogamy, the pollination occurs within the same flower on the same plant. And in jitnogamy, the pollination occurs in between two flowers but on the same plant. Actually, jitnogamy resembles with the autogamy, as well as it also resembles with the cross pollination or jitnogamy. The jitnogamy is genetically same like the autogamy because the plant is same. There is no variation at all. And this is the relationship of the jitnogamy with the autogamy because the plant is same. But what is the relationship of this jitnogamy with the cross pollination? In jitnogamy also, the pollinating agents are required. So, functionally, jitnogamy resembles with the genogamy or cross pollination because in both of the cases, in jitnogamy and as well as in cross pollination, in both of the cases, pollinating agents are required. So, jitnogamy resembles with the autogamy, with the self-pollination, and also it resembles with the cross-pollination on the basis of the pollinating agents. Now, the second type of the pollination is cross-pollination. Cross-pollination is also known as genogamy. Cross-pollination is the transfer of the pollen grains from anther to the stigma of the another plant. Here the pollination takes place from one plant to the another plant. In this case, the condition of the plants is, plants are dioecious, means the male and female plants, both they are separated to each other. So the pollen grains, they are dispersed, they are transferred from one plant to the another plant. And for the cross pollination, we will discuss later on in detail. To transfer the pollen grains from one plant to the another plant, pollinating agents are required. These pollinating agents may be air, water, insects, birds. We will discuss later on in detail. And the genogamy, here two examples I have written, papaya and mint plants. These two plants are unisexual plant, you can say dioecious plant. Now, the types of flower to adopt on the basis to adopt for the pollination. Some of the plants like viola or jelis, comelina, these plants, they have adopted, their flowers are adopted for the self-pollination as well as for the cross-pollination. These plants have two types of the flowers, that is clistogamous flower and chasmogamous flowers. What do you mean by clistogamous flower? It's very, very important, clistogamous and chasmogamous. Clistogamous flowers and Chrysogamus flowers. Both the flowers are bisexual, but the Chrysogamus flower is closed flowers. Here, the stamens, the stamens and carpels, both they are in the close association, and both they are enclosed by other floral parts. The flowers never open, and the Chrysogamous flowers ensures self-pollination and especially autogamy. The Chrysogamous flowers ensure seed set because 100% chances are to be there for the self-pollination, especially for autogamy. The pea plant has Chrysogamous flower. Sometimes there may be the question that why pea plants, they set assured seed because of the presence of Chrysogamous flower. It means the Chrysogamous flowers, they never open, and the process of self-pollination always takes place, and that's why they always produce the seed, the seeds, and that's why there is the assured seeds set. Now the second one is the Chrysogamous flower. The Chrysogamous flower is open flower. Here the flowers are not enclosed by their floral parts, and the pollen grains may be dispersed, may go to the different flowers, and it can prefer the cross-pollination also. So when they need to do the self-pollination, the flowers, they become Chrysogamous. When they wish to do the cross-pollination, the flowers, they may be the Chrysogamous. But all these three plants, Viola, Orgelis, Commelina, these three plants have both types of the flowers, that is Chrysogamous and Chrysogamous. Now, contrivances of self-pollination, or you can say adaptations of the self-pollination, means what are the devices, you can say, by which the self-pollination is ensured. They can do self-pollination. The three main devices are there, or you can say these are the adaptations for the self-pollination. First one, bisexuality. It means if the plant has bisexual flowers, the chance of self-pollination is more. Bisexuality means the flower has both of the sex organ, that is male and female, and bisexual flowers, they prefer self-pollination. Second, homogamy. Homogamy means this is the condition in which the pollen grains and the stigma mature at the same time. When the pollen grains are released from the anther, at the same time the stigma also becomes what? Receptive. Means the maturation of the male and female takes place at the same time. Both they are synchronized at the same time, and if both the male and females both mature at the same time, this condition is called homogamy, and homogamy prefers self-pollination. Now, the third one, that is Chrysogamous flowers. As I told you, the Chrysogamous flowers are closed flowers. If both the sex organs, if the flower is bisexual and the flower is closed, always the pollen grains they set on the stigma and the process of self-pollination takes place. So all these all are the contrivances, or you can say devices, for the self-pollination, and these are bisexuality, homogamy, and the third one is the cleistogamy condition or the cleistogamous flowers. Now, importance of self-pollination. What are the advantages of the self-pollination? When the pollination takes place within the same plant, or you can say, if the self-pollination takes place, what are their importance or advantages? First one, produces homozygous progeny. Homozygous progeny means they transfer the traits of the parents as it is in the progeny, and it brings homozygous progeny means just they are genetically same as their parent, and there is no problem of the dominant and recessive ones. So it brings almost the traits of their parents as it is in the forthcoming generations in the offspring. Used to maintain pure line. Pure line, both the terms are same. Homozygous, when the homozygous conditions are achieved into the offspring, it brings a pure line in all the progeny. It maintains the progeny. Suppose if the plant, the parent plant, is vigorous, has more yield, it has tendency to produce more production, more yield, the same trait may be carried out into their offspring also, in new plants also, and this is possible by the self-pollination. But if the plants are very weaker, have less yield, the progeny plant will also have the less yield regarding the production. No need to produce large number of pollen grains. In the process of self-pollination, the pollen grains are produced little in amount, because they are not transferring from one plant to another plant. The chances of the wasting of the pollen grains are very less. So comparatively, in self-pollinated plants, the number of pollen grains are very less. The next, flowers do not produce attractants for pollinating agents. Generally, the cross-pollinating flowers, they produce some of the attractant, the petals. It becomes very prominent, colorful. It produces nectar to attract the insect even from a very far places. But these type of attractants are not required into the flower. Those who prefer self-pollination. So flower do not produce any attractants. Next, useless characters are eliminated. The genes which are not useful for the plants, gradually they are going to be eliminated. So these are the advantages of the self-pollination. Now, the disadvantages of the self-pollination. The first, no new traits are introduced. As I told you, whatsoever the characteristics are to be there in the parent plant, the same traits are carried out into the progeny. No new traits are introduced. Second, loss of the hybrid vigor. The self-crossing, the continuous self-crossing or self-pollination leads to the loss of the hybrid vigor. Means the productivity gradually decreases in the offspring, in the progeny, and this is also known as inbreeding decrease. The recessive traits also appear. Some of the traits, some of the genes which are recessive in nature, they also appear in the progeny, in the new plants, because here there is no dominant gene with the recessive one. And no way to eliminate defective traits. There is no chance to eliminate the defective gene, or you can say the harmful gene, by the self-pollination method. So that's all about the self-pollination. Let us start with the second one, that is cross-pollination and the contrivances of the cross-pollination. Now I am talking about cross-pollination. The cross-pollination is the transfer of the pollen grains from anther of the one plant to the stigma of another plant. Means here the pollen grains are transferred from one plant to the another plant with the help of some of the pollinating agents. The process of cross-pollination is also known as genogamy. These two plants are there in which the process of cross-pollination takes place, papaya and mage. Now, for the process of cross-pollination, what are the contrivances of the cross-pollination, or you can say, what are the adaptations for the cross-pollination? This is also known as outbreeding devices. Outbreeding devices. This heading is given in your textbook. Outbreeding devices means what are the devices which prefer the process of cross pollination. And these devices are, the adaptations for the cross pollination. The first one is the dichogamy. What is dichogamy? In dichogamy, the maturation time of anthers and stigma is different. Means the maturity time is not synchronized at all. Sometimes the pollen grains are matured earlier, then the stigma becomes receptive, and this is called protendry. 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 In protendry, the anthers mature before the stigma becomes receptive. And in the stigma, becomes receptive before the release of anthers, before the release of the pollen grains from the anther, or you can say if the stigma matures earlier, then the maturation of anther, this is called protogyny. Overall, in dichogamy, the male and female do not mature at the same time. If anther mature earlier than the stigma, this is called protendry. And if stigma becomes receptive before the release of the pollen grains from the anther, this is called protogyny. And because of the maturity time is different, so the pollen grains can be transferred from one flower to another flower, from one plant to the another plant, and this is called dichogamy condition. It means Why not? The flower is bisexual. And if the maturity time of the male and female is not synchronized, it can prefer the process of cross-pollination. Second, heterostyle. What is heterostyle? In some of the plants like in jasmine or jellies, it has been observed that the flower is bisexual, but the position of anther, the position of stamen and carpel is different. In some of the cases, the style is very, suppose this one is the style is very long and in comparison to the style, the anther is, the stamen is very short. So how the pollen grains will be reached here? So because of the different size of the stamen and carpel, or you can say the style, the chance of self-pollination is very less. And it can also prefer, maybe the pollen grains may be dispersed, may go to the different plant, and the chances of the pollination, it can increase the chance of cross-pollination. Now, self-incompatibility. Here also the flower is bisexual, but sometimes the pollen grains fail to germinate on the stigma of its own flower, and this is called self-incompatibility. It means self-incompatibility is the process in which pollen grains fails to germinate on the stigma of its own flower. The stigma do not receive their own pollen grains. It can reject, and that pollen grain can go, can transfer to another plant, and this is called self-incompatibility. And this process of self-incompatibility has been reported in potato plant as well as in tobacco plant. Unisexuality. If the flower is unisexual, definitely the pollen grains will be transferred from one flower to the other flower. So unisexuality prevents autogamy, but unisexuality can't prevent zygotogamy as well as cross-pollination. Means if the flower is unisexual, both the chances are there, it can prefer dichogamy as well as cross-pollination, both, like in the case of papaya and date palm. Now the next one is the hercogamy. What is hercogamy? Hercogamy is the process in which, because of the mechanical barriers, sometimes the pollen grains are not carried out from one plant, are carried out from one plant to the another plant. Like in the case of orchid, the pollen grains are heavier, they are wing-like structure, and such type of pollen grains are always lifted by the insect, and when the insect, they lift the pollen grain, they can transfer the pollen grain to the another plant also. So hercogamy is also a device which prefers cross-pollination. Now the last one is the diocese. or you can say dioecious plant. As earlier I told you, the dioecious plants are the plants which are different, the male and female plants are different. And if the plants are dioecious, they always prefer cross pollination. So these are the devices, all the devices, outbreeding devices, you please note down: dichogamy, heterostyly, self-incompatibility, unisexuality, hercogamy and dioecy. What are the next advantages of the cross-pollination? The cross-pollination overcomes self-sterility. As I told you, the self-sterility, or you can say self-incompatibility, is the inability of the pollen grains to germinate on the stigma of its own flower. If the pollen grains, they do not germinate on the stigma of its own flower, they can germinate maybe on the different flower of this different plant. And therefore, in this regard, the cross pollination is beneficial, which can overcome self stability, or you can say self incompatibility. Second, more yield. It's very, very important. As per yield is to be there, when the cross pollination takes place, the traits of the two plants are combined together, and it has been observed that the new plant can produce more yield, more production. So this one is the importance. The second one, it brings more yield into the new plant, more production. The third, it introduces number of alleles. When the two dissimilar plants or the two plants are there, or when the process of cross pollination takes place, sometimes it can introduce some additional alleles, the genes, into the new plant. And these genes can express the characters. Maybe the new plant may be superior than the parent also. And better offspring. When two dissimilar plants are crossed together, naturally, with the help of the pollinating agents, either by the artificial means, the young ones, the new plants, are better than their parents, and this is called hybrid vigor. Hybrid vigorous means more powerful regarding the production, regarding to resist against the stresses, abiotic stresses, like the new plants can acclimatize, can adapt into the new surroundings, in the scarcity of water, even in the hot climatic condition. So overall, regarding the disease resistance, regarding the abiotic stresses, regarding the production, it has been observed that the new plant is more vigorous, more powerful than their parents. But what are the disadvantages of the cross-pollination? The cross-pollination, the first one, the cross-pollination is highly wasteful processes, as the number of adaptations required. It is a wasteful process. Means, you can see here so many devices I have written, and all these devices, they help in the cross-pollination. So unnecessary. When the process of cross-pollination is required, the plants are supposed to adopt, to develop so many devices, and to develop all these devices, they need a lot of energy, That's why it is a highly wasteful process in this regard. In cross-pollination, the pollinating agents are also required because the pollen grains are non-motile. They have to transfer from one plant to another plant, and to transfer the pollen grains from one plant to the another plant, the biotic as well as abiotic agents are required. These agents are air, water, birds, bats, insects, etc. I will teach you in detail. And the last one is the undesirable characters are also introduced. When the two plants, they produce the new plant, sometimes some of the unwanted, you can say, undesirable traits or the characters may be also introduced, may be also incorporated into the young ones. So these are the disadvantages of the cross pollination, or you can say genome gaming. So that's all. Before I bind this lesson, you please note down some of the questions and you will do in your fair copy. Question number one. What is pollination? What is pollination? Full stop. Differentiate between self-pollination and cross-pollination. Differentiate between self-pollination and cross-pollination. Second, differentiate between following. First, autogamy and genogamy. Autogamy and genogamy. And second, homogamy and dichogamy. Homogamy and dichogamy. Third difference in this question only, the third difference, cleistogamous and chesmogamous flowers. Cleistogamous and chesmogamous flowers. Now, question number three. Write the advantages and disadvantages of self-pollination. Write advantages and disadvantages of self-pollination. Question number four. Explain outbreeding devices. Explain outbreeding devices in plants. Explain outbreeding devices in plants. And the last question, question number fifth. Explain advantages and disadvantages of. Explain advantages and disadvantages of cross pollinating plants. Explain advantages and disadvantages of cross-pollinating plants. I request you all to complete all these assignments. Every day I am giving you 5 questions nearabout. And don't take it lightly. You all are in class 12. You can't say when the school will open to see the present condition of the country. And this year you have to prepare in such a way that in the next year you can appear for the board exam and you will come up with the flying colors. So all these questions are very, very important. It's my humble request to each and everyone to note down all these questions. Some of the students, even they have not joined the e-classes, to whom I also request to join the classes as possible and start completing all these questions. Thanks. Tomorrow I will teach you the next topic.